Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer, and it's Tuesday. Time to look at some online video news from last week and talk about what it means for those of us who are video creators. Starting with, YouTube is now giving you the ability to group your subscriptions into what they call collections. Now, if you're like me and on my family channel, I subscribe to over 400 different channels. It can become really cumbersome to skim through my subscriptions and see all these different channels. It kind of looks like a mess because there's some channels that I don't want to miss a single video that they do. There's other channels that I could just be like, I'll get to it if the title looks enticing. And it's a step in the right direction, but it's not quite where I want it to be. For example, I can come over here to create new collection, and it just gives me all 400 some of them. You know, and it's not really the best way to really, you know, I can click on add some of these, you know, and I can filter them if I want to search for a specific channel, and then I can name it. But it's really a cumbersome way, especially if I want to create multiple collections of different channels. It's really not the most efficient way. What I wish I could do instead was come through this list and actually, you know, check a couple of them and say, hey, all right, all these that I've checked, I want to add to the, you know, such and such collection. But there's no option right here to do that. So until then, I will just do my best to use it, but I really wish that they would make it a little bit easier for those of us who have tons of channels that we subscribe to be able to quickly create different lists and different categories and collections. If you'd like to start organizing your subscriptions into collections, I'll put a link in the description text below on this video here on YouTube that'll take you straight to that page on your account so you can start organizing your subscriptions right away. Also, last week, YouTube made an update to their YouTube editor, which now lets you just add a slow-mo effect to your videos that you upload to your account. Personally, I'm not sure why you would really want to do this. I mean, pretty much any editing program that you have will let you control this in much more detail and do a really good job at it, whether you're using iMovie. I think even Windows Movie Maker even lets you do slow-mo. So it seems to be like a feature for people who are kind of relying on YouTube for their video editing stuff, which I don't know too many people who do, but if that's you, now you can add slow-mo effects to your videos. So let's say that you are a video creator and that you are always continually publishing great, awesome, amazing, free content on your YouTube channel for your subscribers. Well, what if you have some more premium content that you want to sell and, you know, let people pay you to gain access to that video content? Well, if you happen to be researching all the different services out there that let you add a paywall to your videos, search no farther. At realseo.com last week, they posted an article that gives a review on almost all the different services out there that you can use to charge for premium video content. The one that they seem to miss is vidcaster.com, which is one that I like. I don't currently use it, but I do like the guys behind that company, and I think they do a great job. But if you want to check out all the others, that link is in the description text below this video. Go down there, click on it, check it out, and that'll take you to the list of review of tons of different ones that are out there. And finally, it seems like every week there's more and more statistics and data coming out about the growth of online video, and I don't have to convince any of you guys that it is exploding, it is growing and multiplying. I usually don't point them out to you guys in every video because there's always so much of that kind of stuff coming out, but I do want to point you guys to this one because I think it is a good summary of kind of where the industry is and where it's going. Back in 2012, there were over 1 billion worldwide users who watched and consumed online video. By 2017, that number is projected to double to be around 2 billion worldwide users. In 2012, online video consisted of about 57% of all internet traffic. By 2017, that number is expected to rise to about 69% of all online traffic. And when it comes to mobile video, it is expected to grow 16-fold from 2012 to 2017. In 2017, it is projected that mobile video will account for 66% of all mobile data. So the main point is that if you are an individual amateur creator, now is the time to get on the online video wave. And in fact, most of you guys probably are, because if you're even watching this video and caring about what I have to say, you're probably already on that wave. So good for you. At least now maybe you can feel like I do, like, hey, maybe I'm on to something that will one day be way bigger and really catch on. As if it hadn't already. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments below. where do you project that your channel and your video content will be by the year 2017? For me personally, I hope that it'll be not only a full-time income for me and to support my family, but also to support more of you guys and to really just help you guys who have a message that you are passionate about. I want to do my best to help you guys communicate that through online video in a way that really changes people's lives and influences the people who really need to hear what you have to say. So that's what I'm about, and I really hope that video creators by that time can really do that well for you. And if you want to be around this channel in 2017, the first thing you need to do is subscribe. If you haven't already, we'd love to have you join us every week. We talk about online video news and what it means for those of us who are video creators. On Wednesdays, we do some YouTube tips and ideas, suggestions, advice, that type of stuff. And then on Thursdays, we do YouTube Q&A, where we just take any question that you guys have about audience development, YouTube, video stuff, and I do my best to help you guys out the best I can. So subscribe, and I will see you guys again tomorrow. Bye.